City closed now for a third night with no signs that it will be back open before dawn.
Highway 50 has been closed tonight for long periods of time, too, because of scenes like this. This was taken this morning, a tractor pulling that SUV from a snowdrift near Echo Summit. The highway was back open pretty quickly, and thankfully no one was hurt. That section of highway is closed again tonight.
And another reason for the long closures, Caltrans struggling to keep their equipment on the road and running. The agency says that only 6 of its 20 snowblowers, like this one, are working right now. They're working to get more of these machines back online. And ABC 10's Garsh Balsanga joins us live from Colfax, where he spoke with long-haul truckers who are still waiting and using this as a chance to get some rest.
And Garsh Paul, have you heard anything about when the highway might open back up?
Yeah, Luke and Alicia, this is what Caltrans tells us. Tonight, 80 is going to remain closed, so the hope is 80 can reopen sometimes tomorrow. And we're here along Interstate 80 in Colfax, and this is one of the checkpoints that they're turning traffic around. Today, it hasn't been as busy as it's been the past few days, so cars are trying. The highway is still closed, and for truckers, it cannot reopen fast enough. As this latest winter storm winds down, the effects is still being felt in the Sierra. Interstate 80 remains closed for another day as the storm brought blizzard conditions to the higher elevations.
Yep, it's that season.
Forcing truck drivers like Robert McCarlin, who is transporting mail, waiting in Applegate for the freeway to open.
I got all my food, everything, water, everything in the truck.
His daily routine includes sit, sleep, and eat, and do it all over again. He is on night 3.
Yeah, Carrie, I'm going to Reno, then after that I'm going to New York. I've been doing this for 28 years.
So this is not your first rodeo?
No.
And you don't know how long you're going to wait here.
For Shamsuddin, this is his first time. He is praying for the freeway to reopen soon.
Spending time for nothing, yes. Nobody's going to pay you for this time. Nobody. Wait and don't know what's going on there.
I-80 closed Friday evening. About 200 to 300 vehicles stuck in blizzard conditions near Donner Summit. CHP says nobody was injured. The reason the major interstate remains closed as of Sunday, Caltrans says the equipment used to clear the snow quickly has been breaking down due to severe conditions, leaving truck drivers with no other options but to wait.
The old drivers, truck drivers, know that it's bad over there in winter, but you have no choice.
And back out here live along Interstate 80 in Colfax. And for truckers, I-80 is the only option for them to get over the Sierra safely. But Caltrans saying tonight it's going to remain closed. The hope is they can clear enough of the snow that is up there on Donner Summit and remove some of the stranded cars, and that they can remove sometime tomorrow.
A long night ahead for those truck drivers. Our Garsh Balsanga live in Colfax tonight. Thank you.
Yeah, and I-80, one of the busiest roads in America. Mm-hmm. You can imagine how many people in the same boat tonight. Let's get it over to Chief Meteorologist Monica Woods.
And Highway 50 has been much better throughout the course of this storm. However, tonight, look at the backup right here. I know this is a very snowy camera here, but you can see just a little glimpse of Highway 50. Multiple spinouts mean Highway 50 closed tonight as well until they can clear all of that out. So no matter where you go through the high country, it is going to be dangerous travel again. All the local residents trying to navigate their way through a lot of snow coming in. We're starting to see some of that break up right now. Rain showers through the valley also starting to depart as we're heading into this late Sunday evening, moving off to the east. Still seeing some snow from Arnold through 108 and Highway 120 as we move our way up through the high country. Still seeing a lot of snow on I-80 as well as spotty snow showers along Highway 50. It's not necessarily the ongoing snow at this point. It's just the volume of traffic trying to get back down the hill or up the hill that's causing those spinouts and more delays tonight. As far as our bigger picture, things are going to be quieter into our Monday. We're not quite done yet, though. So far, Sierra snow 5 to 8 feet, about a half an inch to an inch of valley rain. Valley rain for the most part over, but our blizzard warning, it continues until midnight. So we still have about 45 minutes to go for that. North of I-80 is that winter weather advisory in place until 4 a.m. with our avalanche warning as well. South of Highway 50 through tomorrow morning. Then we quickly turn our attention back to a winter storm warning. So as soon as the blizzard warning expires, in comes this winter storm warning. That's out ahead of another weather system brewing in the Pacific. Again, tomorrow is probably the best day we're going to see in quite some time. More showers returning by Tuesday.
All right. Thanks, Monica. See you again in a bit. Now, when the snow does finally stop falling, there will be hundreds of stranded trucks and cars on the roads. Plows and towing crews will have the difficult task of having to pull them out of the snow.
A very tough job indeed. Our Devin Truby spoke with a plow driver who had a busy day freeing people from that powder.
Cleanup crews dealing with this constant snowfall, and as the day progresses, the visibility gets lower and lower. This is what crews have had to deal with as they work to clean up Interstate 80.
It's wall-to-wall semi-trucks on both sides of Interstate 80. This 360 view from driver Mike Ram, one of the many tow truck drivers making trips from 80 to Truckee since Thursday.
We're probably estimating probably a little over 200 that were stuck just the other day.
Ram will be joining 9 other North Valley fleet drivers on Interstate 80 pulling cars. Sunday, Ram pulled out 7 cars before 10 a.m.
We either chain them up so they can get out of the snowstorm, so they can either head to Reno or head back down the hill towards Sacramento.
Ram and fellow drivers pulling out semis like this one, hooked up to the back of the truck. Sometimes it taking 2 tow trucks to right this semi that was tipped on its side. Other times, the flatbeds of trucks are filled not with cars, but car parts like this.
There's a lot of people in a lot of cars. Some of them were there overnight. Some of them got rescued and sent to the hospital or to the nearest hotel.
If there's no driver in the car when the tow arrives, the car is impounded. Ram walking us to a nearly full impound lot.
Here, all the way to here, are all abandoned. These are mostly just semi-truck wrecks.
Ram says majority of calls are for spinouts, people going too fast. The other common issue, people in four-wheel drive vehicles, but on city tires.
They're usually happy that we're there to basically get them out of it. They're not too happy when they get the bill. However, they are happy that they got out of it.
The storm crews are working in, taking hold of the town of Truckee this weekend. Just look at this progression of accumulation on the patio furniture. Day 1, Friday. Day 2, Saturday. And now day 3, Sunday. Using this second-story window for reference, it's about 6 feet of snow. Stan Starr thought it would be a great family ski weekend, but sadly, it didn't turn out that way. Now he just hopes his daughter can get home on 50.
She's going to wait for the storm to break. She would like to get home today, but it's less likely.
Starr is former ski patrol for 31 years in Oregon. He says he's seen his fair share of storms, but this one?
You know, I'd say this is a once in a year storm, but, you know, it could be once in 3 years. You know, I mean, it's a pretty big storm.
We reached out to the local hospital to see if they're getting multiple patients off Interstate 80 due to crashes and spinouts. The Tahoe Forest Health System said it's unusually quiet without their normal patients of skiers and snowboarders, so nothing significant to report.